What's up internet, I am Manish from RebellionRider.com and I am back once again with another PL SQL tutorial. Can you recall how many PL SQL collection functions and procedures do we have in Oracle database? Yes, you are absolutely right. We have 7 collection functions and 3 collection procedures in Oracle database. In total, we have 10 collection methods, and among these, we have already discussed the 7 collection functions so far. Now, it's time to move on to the remaining 3 collection procedures. Thus, today in this tutorial, we will discuss the first PL SQL collection procedure, which is delete. But before moving ahead, I just want to remind you to hit that thumbs up button and like the video. Let's see if we can reach 100 likes in a week this time. Also, help others in learning as well as help us and our channel in growing by sharing this video on your social media with your friend. And in case if you are new to our channel, then don't wait, go ahead and subscribe. That being said, let's start the tutorial. As you have already guessed from its name, the PL SQL collection procedure delete removes elements from the collection. This collection method can be used with all 3 types of collections, that are nested table, vArrays, and associative arrays. Collection procedure delete is an overloaded procedure, which means you can use the same procedure in 3 different ways. These 3 different ways are simple procedure call without any parameter. If the PL SQL collection procedure delete is used without any parameter, then it will remove all the elements from the collection. Procedure call with single parameter. This single parameter is the valid index number of the collection. Collection procedure delete called by passing a valid index number will remove the element of the specific index. Procedure call with 2 parameters. This way of calling delete procedure is termed as range delete. In this way of calling, you have to specify 2 indexes, and the procedure deletes the range of elements which fall between start index and ending index. Now, let's write an example and see the practical demonstration of the above discussed theory. This is just a simple program to show you what value is stored at index 5. Let's execute. As you can see, this program returned the value stored at index 5, which is 10. Now, we will modify this same code for demonstrating the all 3 overloaded call of PL SQL collection method delete. Let's start with the second way, which is procedure call with single argument. The first statement inside the execution section is same from the previous code. In the second statement, we have the collection procedure delete call with single argument. And that argument is index number 5. This call will delete the data stored at index 5. And the third statement is an output statement to confirm whether the procedure delete has deleted the data or not. Let's execute and see the result. So, in the result, we received no data found error. This is good. You must be wondering, what is there to be happy about in this error? Actually, let's see this error from the beginning. Initially, we have the output from our first statement, which is the value 10. This shows that there was a value stored at the index 5 before the procedure call. But after the procedure call, we found no data at index 5, which in turn causes the error. This means that our procedure call did its work and deleted the data stored at index 5. And that's exactly what we want, right? What about this error then? It can easily be resolved with proper exception handling or the right use of if-then-else statement. Let me show you. Now, we have properly formatted the code using the if-then-else statement. The if part will execute only if the procedure didn't delete the data from the specific index. Otherwise, the else part will come into the action and show the string data is deleted. Let's execute the program once again and see the result. Here is the desired result. Now, let's see the third way of delete procedure calling, which is range delete. Suppose you want to delete the data from index 2 to index 6. Let's modify this code and see how we can achieve this result. Just a second, I think, yeah. Okay, now everything is good. The first statement in the execution section is the PL SQL collection method delete call with two arguments, which is the starting and ending index. Here, the starting index is 2 and the ending index is 6. This means this procedure call will delete all the elements from index 2 to index 6. Below this procedure call, we have a for loop which is displaying the stored data from our collection. This loop will show you the data only from those indexes which are not empty because of this if condition. Let's execute and see the result. Here we are. You can see in this result set that we don't have rows returned from index 2 to 6. Now that you have learned how to use collection method delete to remove elements from a specific index or from range of index, let's move on to the only case which is left, that is the first one, which is PL SQL collection procedure delete with no argument. How about you try this case all by yourself? Go ahead and try it. If you want me to review your code, then you can send me your program on my Facebook or Twitter. Links are in the description. Also, you can take help from the blog on the same topic. There you can also find more in-depth knowledge about the topic along with all the possible questions that you may face in an interview or your certification exam. That's the tutorial on PL SQL collection method delete in Oracle database. Hope you enjoyed watching and learned something new. Please do make sure to like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.